All right, what's going on, guys? As you know, I recently picked up an S14, and I plan on building it, or not building it, well, building it later, but getting it as reliable as possible right now to become my daily. I do still have the Mazda 3, but I'll talk about that in another video. So today, basically, I'm just going to do a walkthrough, kind of, and tell you what I've done to the 240 so far, and yeah. A lot of people have asked, do I still have the S13? Yes, I do. The plans for this are going to be revealed in a later video. Yep, that Sylvia front end looking nice. And here's the S14. I'm going to turn around actually. Alright, so I'm gonna go out and say a lot has changed actually from the last time you saw this car. I've already done a lot and I didn't get to record it because I'm still in the process of moving. So I actually lost my camera and yeah, I'm just gonna get into it. So previously these wheels had like, okay, these are really shitty plastic dipped, but for some reason the previous owner thought it was a good idea to paint those lips like white. And it was the ugliest thing in the world, so I just went ahead and plastic dipped them black. I didn't even like prep them or anything, kind of just wiped it down and then just held the plastic dip can and sprayed it. Previous owner also plastic dipped these and these for some god awful reason, I don't know. The paint looks okay. It looks like a Mako paint job with some chips here and there. But yeah. Other than that though, everything looks clean. The body lines are straight. There's no frame damage, rarely any rust. Let's see. Oh, also got this new exhaust. Ew, what is this? The old exhaust was like straight up like some random muffler shop welded like an epoxy tip to like, yeah, it was just really ugly and it sounded like crap. So I got these, one of these. Dual tipped exhaust, one of my favorite looks. Let's see. So moving on to the interior, guys. Rarely have I seen 240s with full interiors, but this happens to be one of them. It's a little messy. Like I said, I'm in the process of moving, so I'm kind of using my cars as little storage units for now until I get situated. But yes, interior looks good. There's a hole right here. The previous owner was a big dude, so it makes sense. These parts right here are a little worn down. Let's see. This I put in myself. This is from my the Vert actually. So I have a quick release NRG steering hub, quick release to a Momo steering wheel. Horn doesn't work. I don't know what the previous owner tried to do here. Yeah, either tried to got really excited in the car one day and just splooged everywhere, or tried to repair this with some epoxy. System works, which is rare. AC does not work, which is a bummer, but can't ask for everything, I guess. Other than that, 5-speed, you know, everything works in here. And also, guys, I put a Circuit Sport shifter bushing in here, because when I first got the car, literally I could put it in first gear and the shifter right here was able to touch both sides of the bezel, like not even trying to exaggerate or anything, like in any gear actually it would just have so much play. Like, I mean, KA transmission are known for having play in their wall and gear, but this was ridiculous, guys. So I went in there and I changed that bushing out, and yeah, it was super mint. Now it shifts and it doesn't grind. It used to grind in reverse. Let's see it. Oh wait, it's not even reverse. No, what? Oh, there it is. Okay, there. But yeah, see, it used to grind super, like, it used to do that. Not anymore. And even stationary in third and fourth, it used to grind, but not anymore. Look at that, super mint. So that's that. Let's go into the engine bay. All right, so into the engine bay. Mostly what I've done here is all maintenance. I got a new air filter because the old one had a hole in it, as you previously saw. did new cap and rotor, did new spark plug wires, new spark plugs that were down in there. I replaced 3 of the 4 injectors because, like I said, all my 240s have always had injector issues, so I just went ahead and replaced all of them with remanufactured ones. This is the OEM one because it looked really good, so I just decided to keep it. I went ahead and did an EGR delete, which is back here, and it was the biggest bitch in the world to do. So these holes actually lead to these vacuum tubes actually lead to nothing. I have to delete this whole thing, and I'll get to that soon. I just need to get some fuel lines, and then it should be good. There's the EGR block off plate in there. You can't see. I also installed this ISR fuel pressure regulator because I went ahead and redid the whole fuel system. So I did the injectors, fuel filter, the FPR, and I even put an ISR fuel pump into the gas tank. And that helped with the starting issue that the car had in the beginning. It kind of would take forever to start because I'd have to give it gas and hold it. So that's all good. Let's see. This ground right here, like the main ground wire, was like loose, and I did all that and the car was still bogging so slightly. And then I came in here, I was like, what the fuck? And it was so loose, dude. Like, that's another one big thing, guys, to check for any car, really. If you're having bogging issues, hesitation issues, and you've done everything else, make sure you check your grounds, because they actually play a really big role in how well the car runs. Other than that, guys, it's how I got it. I bled all the brakes because this was like super like disgustingly brown. Now there's clear fluid in there, but yeah, everything else pretty much stock, and the car runs super healthy right now for a KA, which is hard to say. These are some of the most unreliable engines I've ever worked on in my life, but this one's running. Let me go ahead and turn it on for you. So the car's on, it's warming up. As you can see, the RPMs, oh my god, I cannot, like, when I first got this car, the RPMs would just jump and be like, and right now it's warming up, it's gonna stay consistent, and then when it warms up, it drops, the RPM drops, and it also, like, stays consistent, and it's just so crazy. I've never had a 240 that runs this well. Just goes to show how much a little maintenance goes a long way. So let's go out here, listen to the exhaust. Yeah, let's go ahead and listen to the engine. Before, the engine would like shake, like it would idle, shake, idle, shake. I mean, it's kind of doing it right now, but I can't tell if that's either from like it misfiring or the engine mounts need to go. But yeah, see the fuel pressure right there. Give her a little. Yeah, dude, it's crazy. Before, right when I got the car, I would do that and like it would rev and it'd go so low, it'd be like it was about to die. And then barely keep alive, but right now you'll rev it and it'll just, yep, a little backfire, open headers. But yeah, it stays consistent as fuck, and it's crazy. I've never had a 240 running this well. I can't say that enough. Now that you see the car is adequately warmed up and the RPM, oh, hold on, it's still on. Let me show you. There you go, car's still on. Just want to give you a rev to let you know. And the RPMs are chilling, bro, just right there, having a grand old time. Like, it's crazy, man. Like, this is the most reliable 240 I've ever owned, and I cannot say that enough because that makes me really happy, honestly. Granted, I did do a lot of maintenance stuff, but that's maintenance, and that's to be done on any car you buy. That's not brand new off the lot. But yeah, so what I paid for this car, 31. It was up for 38, and we agreed on 35 before I even decided to drive out there. I told him, yeah, I'll give you 35, man. But then I got out there. It took him forever to start the car, and I was like, holy shit, I cannot believe I drove all this way for this. And, what's it called? It was bogging, like, super hard. Like, it would idle, bog, like, you could see the engine, like, shake. And then I asked him a few questions, like, yo, when's the last time you changed spark plugs? When's the last time you did this? He's like, oh, I don't know, man. I kind of just stopped driving it, and I got a Subaru WRX. Hits vape, tips fedora. I was like, Jesus fuck. But yeah, so I picked it up anyways. I spent like 2 hours at the AutoZone parking lot. And yeah, I got it running. I got just good enough to get home, and I parked it, and I didn't drive it until I did a bunch more maintenance. And now she's running mid, and I'm super happy. And I got this daily. I'm gonna try to daily this. It needs a few more things, like brakes, five lug swap. I'm probably gonna take the wheels off the vert here and put a four lug on that, just because that's gonna be a drift slut now. But yeah, guys, so it's looking up from here. And yeah, if you want to follow the rest of the S14 build, make sure you drop a subscribe, leave a comment, because I love that shit. And yeah, all right, guys, and before I go, one last thing. These stickers are still available. I only sold 3, and I think it's because I made the buying process so ridiculously difficult. So if you want to buy one, go ahead. I'll shoot the PayPal for you to send $4 to in the description, and then just send $4 there and make sure the address is correct, and I'll send you one over. Only $4, guys. These things are super mint. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and put one on the vert right now, so yeet. Alright, guys, this is where I decided to put the decals. One of my favorite spots, because they're super rice right above the exhaust, so it burns the decal kind of. And yeah, this decal isn't like super thin, it's like actually pretty thick. Looks like Jerome uses nice vinyl for these. So, yep, $4, guys. Get yourself a riced out sticker to put on a rice ass part of your car. But I'm ballin', ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing. I made a promise to my mama, I'ma turn these zeros into tens of commas.